Hello everyone, the journal for today is prognostic value of von Willebrand factor for patients with AF, a meta-analysis of prospective cohort studies, and my moderator is Dr. Ajitina. These are the authors. AF is the most common arrhythmia in the clinic. The prevalence of AF in the general population is about 1%. AF increases the risk of cerebrovascular events 5-fold and the risk of death 2-fold. Therefore, enhancing awareness of risk factors and taking relevant measures are particularly important to prevent an adverse prognosis. The commonly used methods for assessing risk factors of AF prognosis are the CHA2DS2VASc score for assessing the risk of stroke and thromboembolism. However, the assessment methods of AF prognosis, such as cardiovascular events and deaths, are incomplete and lack conclusive evidence. Von Willebrand factor is closely related to cardiovascular disease. Von Willebrand factor is mainly synthesized by endothelial cells, and plasma von Willebrand factor levels are a hallmark of endothelial injury or dysfunction. It is important to clarify the impact of von Willebrand factor on the prognosis of patients with AF. The research methodology of the journal. The objective of this meta-analysis is to evaluate the association between von Willebrand factor levels and the clinical prognosis of patients with AF. It includes a literature search, which includes PubMed, Embase Web of Science, Cochrane Library, and Van Fang database. They are searched from their inception to July 2019 using the keywords that included von Willebrand factor and AF. The inclusion criteria for this meta-analysis was all the studies involving non-valvular AF and von Willebrand factor, not valvular AF, then papers of the cohort study type only, and studies which had follow-up time of more than 6 months, and studies which involved endpoints containing at least one of the following: all-cause death, cardiovascular death, adverse cardiovascular events, myocardial infarction, stroke, heart failure, and recurrence of atrial fibrillation. Studies involving the following were excluded out: experiments carried out on animals, reviews, case reports, letters, repeat publications, subjects with valvular disease AF, acute coronary syndrome, stroke, unstable angina, or any patient with hemodynamic abnormalities. The quality evaluation was done using PRISMA method, preferred reporting items for systematic reviews, and meta-analysis method. The quality of the literature included in the study was done using the Newcastle-Ottawa scale. Newcastle-Ottawa scale is used for assessing the quality of randomized study. The statistical analysis. Hazard ratio was used as a statistic to assess the impact of von Willebrand factor on the prognosis of AF. Hazard ratio values more than 1 indicate high von Willebrand factor levels, which are risk factors for the patient. The chi-square test was used to assess the heterogeneity of the included studies, which was quantitatively assessed in combination with I-square test. Chi-square and I-square are two attributes of heterogeneity of a test. When p is less than 0.05, I-square more than 50%, this indicates that there is statistical heterogeneity in the study. This table shows the diagram for literature search, how articles were selected. Finally, 12 articles were included in the meta-analysis. The characteristics of the studies are: all the 12 studies included in the meta-analysis are of the cohort study type. What we note here is that Asians are not part of the ethnicity or nationality in the studies, so that may be one of the limitations, which I'll be talking about later on. Outcomes: acute coronary syndrome, myocardial infarction, thromboembolic events, stroke, TIA has been included in the outcomes of each and every study. This table suggests the values of von Willebrand factor and the primary endpoint, the all-cause death and cardiovascular death. These studies try to correlate higher von Willebrand factor levels with all-cause mortality and cardiovascular death. Overall, the quality of the retrieved literature was good, and the NOS, that is Newcastle Ottawa Scale Quality Assessment Scale, assessed all study scores as more than 6 points. The Newcastle Ottawa Scale has a maximum score of 9, with a greater score indicating the lowest risk of bias. You may study the impact of von Willebrand factor, or rather the correlation of von Willebrand factor with each and every outcome, such as all-cause death, cardiovascular death, and stroke. So coming to von Willebrand factor and all-cause death. From the table above, it's clear that regardless of the length of follow-up and size of the sample, high von Willebrand factor levels increase the risk of all-cause mortality in patients with AF. Coming to von Willebrand factor and cardiovascular death, what we see on the right is the forest plot. It is a statistical diagram which helps us explain association. The previous table shows that the risk of cardiovascular death was related to von Willebrand factor levels and was affected by the follow-up period and its sample size. Studies with smaller sample size and longer follow-up show that high von Willebrand factor levels did not increase the risk of cardiovascular death. Von Willebrand factor and major adverse cardiac events. It shows that between von Willebrand factor and major adverse cardiac events, the sample size has a bearing on the results. Studies with smaller sample sizes show a positive correlation between major adverse cardiac events and high von Willebrand factor levels. Von Willebrand factor and stroke. Studies with shorter follow-up show that high von Willebrand factor levels increase the risk of stroke in patients with AF. The strength of this meta-analysis lies in its attempt to clarify the relationship between von Willebrand factor levels and AF outcomes. Data from this study demonstrates that von Willebrand factor as a biomarker can be combined with the CHA2DS2VAS score in AF patients to optimize the risk of AF stroke that may guide anticoagulant therapy. The limitations are, studies have variable sample sizes. The two of the studies had very small sample size. Variation in the length of follow-up or cutoff value for von Willebrand factor. The range, normal range for von Willebrand factor is different in different studies, and type of AF considered also is different. This can be the cause for heterogeneity or bias. And Asians and young people account for a small proportion, so the results may not be applied generally. The conclusion of this meta-analysis is that von Willebrand factor is a poor prognostic marker for patients with AF, as it depends on several other factors. Two related reports. In this scientific report, does von Willebrand factor improve the predictive ability of current risk stratification scores in patients with AF? It's concluded that von Willebrand factor acts as a simple prognostic biomarker in AF, and while its addition to current scores statistically improves prediction for some endpoints, this VWF marker has little impact on clinical decision making. This related study has shown that patients with AF show higher von Willebrand factor activity. And treatment with traditional oral anticoagulants significantly reduced von Willebrand factor levels. Patients without oral anticoagulants might have had an increased risk of thrombotic events, showing higher von Willebrand factor levels. Patients with stroke had higher von Willebrand factor activity. So this study suggests that there is some relation between von Willebrand factor levels, the increased von Willebrand factor levels, and cerebrovascular disease. So it can be a useful biomarker for stroke in AF. Thank you.